All right. He wants to keep you on your toes, huh? Okay, that's a good reason, but there's another reason, probably, I would say, would be more viable than that. That's good, though. Very good. God wants you to remember. Okay, I would say this, Sister Deborah. I would say God can't do anything for nobody unless we ask Him. The only way God legally can intervene on this earth, which is the planet, is what? Really dominated and ruled by who? Satan. For us to legally get to operate and to have authority over Satan down here, we have to do it through the authority that we have through what? Christ. You got to get saved. And you got to what? Have power and authority over the enemy. And for that reason, God can't do anything legally for anybody unless we what? Ask Him. Unless we come to an agreement and hook up with Him and petition things. Is that right?
Yeah, for us to remember and agree.
Yeah, right. Okay.
We remember what you said. We agree with what you said. We're saying what you said.
Right. So God can only do stuff like heal and bless and prosper you. That has to be done through our rights and privileges as what? As believers. Because Satan is the god of this world, right? And the only way that we can supersede his authority and his dominion is that we have to do it in the spirit realm, spiritual realm. Is that right? Y'all get that? Is that right? All right, so that's a good question. Although God knows that he knows everything and we can't remind him in reality, you know, in terms of he doesn't forget, but he knows that we can't really receive unless we do it. He said, ask and it shall be given, right? Seek and ye shall what? This is the way that God has designed for us to receive things. Be careful for nothing, but in all things by what? Prayer and what? Supplication with what? Thanksgiving. Let your request be made what? And the what? Peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your heart and mind.
But if we're not being consistent in that, I mean, you know, just does me, isn't it? So why then are we like okay, or things are still okay for us?
Okay. Okay, that's a good question. She said, suppose we're not really fully committed to doing it God's way, but yet things seem to go pretty good with us. Still making. Still blessed. Well, that's a good question then.
He said, if you're not confessing what God's saying.
Well, I mean, you know, so I'm not walking around like that, or maybe I haven't taken the time. I do it the other day, but I didn't do it today. You know, I don't put in the time.
Yeah. And this scripture right here, where he was focusing on, he said, when those bad times come and hit you, okay, then will you remember what God said?
Right.
And will you agree with what God said? So Romans 10:10 says that the confession of it would bring salvation. So when the bad time, when the negative hits, then you have to know.
Yeah.
Now, if you just say that I don't every day habitually say things that pertain to something negative that happened, but mm-hmm. here he's, the bad incident happened, so you can say that bad incident there, I'm going to confess over that bad incident there.
Well, the thing is that many times we don't always confess everything that we receive all the time. But many times we probably are walking in the reality of it supernatural. For instance, you might be praising God, or you might be consistently in a state of praise, and it'll still happen. If you delight yourself in the Lord, you don't have to really pray. Well, delight is still a way of praying.
Yeah.
So if you're just always happy, always rejoicing, thanking God and praising God, then you're already covered. Things are going to happen. But that's all right.
The context of what? I was just going to say, so I agree, knowing the context too of what we're going with this.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, now.
As well, you may have done something good or blessed someone.
So all of it's flowing, all of it's working.
Yeah, sometimes I can't confess everything that God has promised to actually receive the reality of it in that respect. But I'm always praising God. I'm always on cloud 13. So I'm covered. Praising God. Singing in the Spirit, praising God. Rejoice and delight yourself in the Lord. Rejoice, O ye lands. Shout for joy. And God will do great things. So you stay happy. You kind of in good shape. When you start looking long faces, heart is heavy. Get downcast, get discouraged, pity party, then it's not going to work for you. Okay, now, Jehoshaphat and them, what they did was that after they prayed this prayer, then God released his released direction. The Spirit of God began to move, and God spoke to the prophet, and he told the prophet exactly what Israel needed to do in order to be delivered from the enemy that had surrounded them round about. So the instruction was that they didn't have to fight. All that would happen was stand still and see the salvation of God. But in the process of standing still, they were encouraged to what? Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. And that was their weapon. Amen. And as a result, the enemies were what? They were what? They were destroyed. And Israel triumphed, and the battle was won, and Israel experienced victory just because they praised the Lord. The instructions was praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Go out and say, the Lord is good, his mercy endures forever. That was the thing that caused God to set ambushment against the enemy, and every single one of them were what? Were admired. That's a good example. So praising God for what you're believing for is really important. All of the victories in the Old Testament were practically, probably all of them, were won the same way. God gave them a promise, and they came in agreement, they believed. Some instances they had to fast and pray, but ultimately they were told to what? Rejoice and praise God for the victory before the victory even what came. God considers this as the highest kind of faith. That's the reason I'm trying to get y'all what? Praise the Lord. You're down and out, things ain't going, get everything what? Give thanks.
Yeah.
Right? Rejoice evermore, is that right?
Yeah.
Rejoice, come on, rejoice. Don't be looking at all these sad faces. Amen, praise God. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and what? All that is within me. Bless his holy name. Then we release God to what? Do what he can do best. Heal all of your sin.
Woo!
Heal all of your what? Just be crown you. You want some love and kindness?
Woo!
Crown you with love and kindness. And tender mercy. And satisfies your mouth with what? Good things so that your what? You is renewed like the eagle. If you want to release God, amen, then give him what he wants. This pleases God more than anything you can offer. Hallelujah. How many can say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
All scriptures are admonishing you to praise God for whatever you are what? Believe in God. Praise him for it before he what? Does it.
Yes.